السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we'll talk about an experience that my uncle, the oldest one of the family of Al-Banna, had. After his wife died, then after his son martyred in 1973 war, he was living alone in Mansoura, and his elder son, or the only son left, he asked him to come and live with him in Cairo. All my uncles from my father were actually Azhari, educated in Azhar University. My old uncle Az-Zaki, my father, my uncle Abdul Hadi, Ahmed Abdul Hadi, and my uncle Mustafa as well. So his son was very kind to him. He gave him a room, put all the facilities in the room for him to live a very comfortable life. And at that time, the television was something new that everybody is using. And he bought the television in the room and told him how to use the television. My uncle, as an old man, yani, used to sleep after Isha, and that's it. But he used to, after he got the television, used to watch the television to see X and Y and Z, maybe some news, maybe some drama. Then one day he stopped and told him, please take this devil out of my room. He said, what do you mean, my father? He's telling his son. He said, my son, since I start watching this television or this machine, I stopped seeing my colleague, ulama and qurra and zuhad and ubad in my dreams. I started not seeing the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Please, my son, I want to have my privacy and don't want this television in my room. I heard the discussion between him and my father when he came to visit us in our house in Cairo at that time. This is what happened to us. When we see the drama, when we see the movies, when we see some program and others, this distracts us. When we pray in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the scenes could come in front of you. So to let us lose our focus and concentration on the proper worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here I remind all of you and myself of what happened to Sayyidina Sa'id ibn Amr, the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who saw Sayyidina Khubayb was tortured and slaughtered and by the Qurayshite kafir people. And Sayyidina Sa'id ibn Amr at the time was not a Muslim. Then he became Muslim later on. Then he became Muslim. He was blaming himself of not supporting Sayyidina Khubayb at that time and failing him while he was tortured. And used to go in this deep convulsion and sometimes coma, because he failed to support Sayyidina Khubayb. The moral of the story here is, I'm not asking you not to watch television and not to do this, but I'm asking us, all of us, to be careful. Because when I see a drama or a movie and I like a part of it, when I started to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pray, I remember the actor and the actress and the joke and the scene, and they don't focus on Allah. And it's exactly what my uncle told his son and what my uncle told my father, that I don't want this because this is distracting me. And he called this machine as a devil. I don't want it to be in my room. This is his philosophy and the philosophy of the people who were actually born at the end of 19th century and lived through the first 60 or 70 years of the 20th century. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.